spoon.
Mmm, that's crunchy. Oh. That's not really what I want in the morning.
Not bad.
Just a salty snack.
Kinda tastes like a raisin, actually.
It's like a really salty sunflower seed.
Okay, no. That was great.
Oh, it's actually good. Okay, it's not so bad. Mmm, no, it's good. I like it.
I feel like I'm tasting the future.
They are healthy for you, healthier for the environment, and can taste amazing if you know how to cook them. Healthy for you, I'm sure you've heard a lot about the protein in insects. We have here like awesome protein bar companies like Lithic and Chapul. They taste great, they're packed, but it's not just the protein. Insects have a ton of microvitamins, like omega-3 to 6s, the healthy fats. They're full of those. They have more iron, calcium, etc., than your typical protein sources.
There's an industry growing in Western communities or countries that is constituted of cricket farms, mealworm farms, and bugs raised for human consumption. After a little digging, I found out that it was a pretty cool industry, sustainable, nutritious, made a lot of sense. Started blogging about what I was finding. When I would do blog interviews for Buggable, my favorite question to ask was, how did you become an entomo enthusiast, or what's your bug story? A huge factor for most was the 2013 FAO and UN report that was released. It goes into detail about by 2050, we're going to have a population of about 9 billion. Insects aren't the only solution, but they present an extremely viable solution for addressing population growth, hunger, food insecurity.
My first edible insect experience came in Thailand in 2006. I was sitting in this beautiful beachfront bungalow bar, and instead of pretzels or peanuts for the bar snacks, there's fried crickets and there's bamboo worms. And it's one of those things that, like, the moment you start that hand to mouth, realize what you're eating, and you're like, this is actually pretty good. So I came back to the US in 2006 and went to all my friends and was like, yo, eating bugs, this is super cool, we should all be doing this. And we started the first insect farm in US history to be inspected by the FDA for human food grade consumption.
So this right here, this is a cricket farm.
Right, I mean, this is amazingly space efficient. You're using so many fewer resources to produce a pound of insects compared to a pound of soybeans or a pound of beef. We're using really high quality feed and really amazing practices to kind of get the best flavor out of these crickets. There was the law in Maine that you couldn't feed prisoners lobster more than twice a week because it was considered inhumane, and now people pay $30 to $50 a pound for it.
Most people aren't consuming bugs on a daily basis here in the United States.
Right, and that's supply chain issues. There simply aren't enough farms to supply the insects that people want. I mean, we get 10 times our maximum production capacity in orders each month.
So you guys are actually turning away orders?
Constantly, and unfortunately.
For every pound of beef farmed to table, it takes 1,700 gallons of water to do that. For a pound of cricket protein farmed to table, it takes 1 gallon of water. So it's a pretty crazy sustainability ratio, and that's just the tip of the iceberg.
I think that we can learn a lot of what not to do from the livestock industry. At my farm, which is arguably a very small entity, we are able to operate a shipping container in the middle of Denver in a really urban area. We do not need running water. The waste that we pull out of there is actually a fertilizer at maximum capacity, which we haven't hit yet. It'll raise 250 pounds of crickets per month.
The ick factor refers to the cultural revulsion associated with certain foods. And it's not just bugs. There's a lot of things that some cultures enjoy, others find disgusting, and vice versa. Most people think biting into bugs will be this Timon and Pumbaa, guts bursting everywhere experience, but it's not. Most of them are cooked and dehydrated and taste kind of like nuts, which is surprising.
Oh well, Hakuna Matata. Slimy, it's satisfying.
This book has been in print for almost 20 years now. The original had 30 recipes for cooking with everything from little termites and ants all the way up to big tarantula spiders. And the new book has 40 recipes in it. I had this whole file folder full of articles, mostly from science journals, about cultures around the world that eat bugs, which I thought was really fascinating. And I started thinking, why don't we eat bugs? I mean, what's our trip?
Guys, these are grasshopper kebabs, okay. Teriyaki marinated, quite delicious. I heartily encourage that you try one.
Okay, Anna, do you want to try it? You want to try one?
I am trying for everyone.
We're in that, they say 80% of the world's cultures eat bugs. We're in that 20% that does not, and we think it's weird.
All right, buddy, nice. Cheers. Nice. You win.
I do already.
Normal is just a setting on a washing machine. Well, the stuff that we consider normal is basically what our parents or our grandparents gave us.
When we're trying to overcome a stigma, we're not going to change an entire population's mind about insects. What we can do, though, are find people that are willing to eat insects once and then focus on getting them to eat insects again and again and again, that repeat user. As an industry, we're really focusing on making it easy for people who would eat insects anyway. They just didn't know about it. It's an education, not a disgust issue. Giving those individuals access to affordable, sustainable, edible protein. I think sushi is a really good indicator of the direction insects can take. First, totally appalling, then totally trendy. Insects in general can be either a substitute for meat or any other protein source of a dish, or an addition to existing dishes. When I'm hosting a bug dinner with a restaurant, I'll typically talk to the owner, say, hey, this will be really cool to showcase your chef's talents and attract a new audience. I promise we can get some good press about this. And I'll go talk to the chef and we'll pick menu items and recreate them with insects. It's important that people aren't just misled into eating insects, but are convinced that insects are a normal ingredient. Just like that cow or that chicken or that fish, that cricket and that mealworm can belong on your dinner table.
I like the idea that people should see what they're eating and know what it tastes like. And if it's really good, and believe it or not, tarantulas are really good, that's going to swing them over. So I'm much more into the, what do we say here, the whole foods perspective of things.
So in terms of insects for the protein powder, whole insects, like my preferred method of delivery is I want people to look my bugs in the face. People aren't gonna go out and try them on their own. They have to like be peer pressured in order to do it. But the farmer's market, people trying them at restaurants that they already know and trust, these are the types of things that really grow human food consumption of insects in the US.
we as an industry are moving slowly but surely towards a point where insects will be available in the grocery aisle. And it could be, you know, you're walking down your Vons or whatever grocery equivalent and see the scallops and the shrimp and then the crickets in the frozen section. To get there, honestly, it's just a matter of a group attack on education, putting curriculums into schools, on influence, getting people that others admire to eat insects. It's just making insects normalized. When people look at companies, they often say, oh my gosh, it's an overnight success. Like, this event happened and this company turned into a $1 million unicorn. And we often look for that same thing in industries or Fortune 500 companies to tech startups. However, what actually happens is more like when you see an egg hatch. When a little chicken comes out of an egg, you don't say, miraculously, overnight, this egg hatched. Instead, we have this knowledge that it's a slow build, very complicated, hard at times, this momentous building process inside the egg. And only when it breaks through does it become apparent to the public all the hard work that went into that. So with the edible insect industry, I don't think we're going to have an event or a moment where suddenly everyone decided to eat bugs and it was great. But instead, we're going to have a really slow build with really deliberate, intentional movers and shakers contributing their 2 cents or, you know, $100 to the cause, and keeping that patience and keeping that hope and excitement alive is going to be incredibly important in the road we have ahead. Wow, I learned a lot about edible insects today.